A manipulator will try to impose his idea on you. A manipulator will use feelings of shame, guilt, or even feelings of love to impose his ideas on you. For example, a person might say, "I really worry about you being stressed for the last few months at work. I don't think that you should take this new position." And it looks like this person really cares about you. But if a month later you realize that this person, your coworker, got your promotion instead of you, then you know that this was not care, that was manipulation. So another example, parents often use feelings of guilt to convince their children to study a specific major at the university. When you hear words like, "What would your father say if he knew that you had decided not to follow this promising career path?" So this is manipulation. Another example, a manipulator can use authority and scare tactics. For example, at work, a coworker can say to you something like this: "The last time that the person decided to discuss his idea with boss, he was fired. So I don't recommend you to talk to boss about any new ideas that you have." So this is how a person uses scare tactics and authority figures. So you don't have to talk to boss because he will fire you. So in reality, this coworker does not want you to be the smart one, does not want your boss to love you more. In reality, he worries about his own position, and he does not want your boss to notice you. So he wants basically to pull you down, and so you're gonna be equal. And later he will use maybe your ideas to talk to boss and to promote himself. Another example of authority tactics. A mother can say to a child something like this: "If you don't stop crying immediately, I'm going to tell your father about your bad behavior and he will punish you when he comes back home." So this mother is trying to use authority figure and scare the child. In reality, this mother, she feels hopeless. She does not know how to communicate with the child. The child is not listening, and she is lost. And this type of manipulation, not really a bad one, because in this example, a mother kind of shows her child that father is a leader, that his father is a strong man, and he has a power. She said, "I will tell your father and he will come back and punish you." So she basically shows the child that father is a god and strong and powerful. Maybe it's not the best way to do it, but in a way she still kind of shows superiority and respect towards her husband. So if you don't want to fall into this second type of manipulation, you should pay attention when people use feelings of guilt, shame, or even love to convince you to do something that you want, or when people use authority figures or scare tactics.